appreciate it.
Okay, so the date of the next fire commission meeting is June 5th. Now moving on to item I, park and recreation matters. We have the draft minutes of the commission meeting from April 24th. I just have one typo, and then Carolyn. Yes. Near the, in the second page, second paragraph, bowls instead of moles.
No, that's actually not a typo, it's a ball.
It's a bowl?
Different type of apartment.
Okay, I learned something new, thank you, that is totally awesome.
It's a virtual mall bowls.
They migrate.
I read that, I was like, no way.
That is the creature.
Okay. Does anyone have any questions or comments from that? Did you have something else?
No, I mean, it's pretty straightforward.
Anybody else? Any comments from the public on the draft minutes of the park and rec commission meeting?
Yes.
Steven?
So at the beginning of the meeting, I came to the meeting, I was surprised, I just wanted to say something about the shed and the nature trail, and I was surprised that a full presentation had been planned and, along with invitations to five members of the public. Now, I actually spoke for quite some time about how the Brown Act was violated. The description was not in the meeting, and I'm sorry to say, I mean, Carolyn's just kind of avoiding the uncomfortable, and I just wish if you're going to report, let's report what happened. So that is certainly one of the worst violations of the Brown Act that I've seen. It's apparent that you wanted to keep discussion of that facility as quiet as possible to avoid the meeting that happened the year before, where we had, what, 40, 50 people here, many of whom had objected to that use, that site. So anyhow, that'll come up later, but I have some comments for that, but that's the main thing I wanted to say.
All right, thank you. Any other questions, comments from the public on the PNR commission meeting? Linda?
The only thing I wanted to say was, had I known that there was going to be a presentation, I would have been there, certainly. I too think it's a Brown Act violation, and this, I believe, is very similar to what the board of supervisors, the county board did a couple of years ago and was fined heavily for holding a meeting, talking about something big when nobody ever knew about it. So I think it's in your best interest to follow the law. This is a Brown Act law that says if you're going to be doing something, you should make it very clear what you're going to be doing. And on the agenda, it was a 20-minute item to discuss, as things have been discussed and discussed and discussed for 2.5 years now. It never said anything about a presentation. So I would have liked to have seen that had I known about it. Thank you.
Thank you. All right.
Can I just say, I don't believe it was a Brown Act violation, and I don't believe that it's actually the same as what Linda just described. It was an item that was clearly listed on the agenda as a topic, as it has been, and as much as it is tonight.
So does it have to go to court to decide this? Because you can review the supervisor.
Steven, you're out of line. Okay, let's move on.